Did you know you can get to the right answer in a quantitative question in a case interview and still do poorly? Hey everyone, I'm Bruno, and in this video I'm gonna show you the number one mistake that candidates make in quantitative questions in case interviews. This is a mistake that even candidates who are strong on the quant side make, and that can make or break your chances of getting the offer. I'm also going to show you how to avoid making this mistake. Through the years helping candidates get their offers at McKinsey, BCG, and Bain, I've seen many candidates who consider themselves really strong at maths being rejected from these firms because they weren't analytical enough. Now, these are candidates with backgrounds in engineering, math, even PhDs in sciences. I've even seen it happening once with an economist who had a master's in math and a PhD in statistics. So what is this mistake? Very simple. Once these candidates finished their quantitative analysis during their cases, they were so happy that they got to the right number that they forgot to go a step further and tell the interviewer what that number meant for the client. So say for example that your case is about a beauty products retailer who's trying to create a growth strategy. And one of the analyses that you have to do is to find out how much more market share do they need in order to reach a certain revenue growth target. Now, let's say you found that they need to grow from 15% to 25% market share. What a lot of candidates would do here is to announce those numbers to the interviewer and to give themselves a pat in the back. They should be happy, right? They found the right number. That's their job. And the answer is no, that's not their job. Their job as consultants is to help the clients understand what they should do. And to do that, they need to help the clients understand what these numbers mean to them. It's more about the meaning of the numbers than about the numbers themselves. Now, two practical tips on how to do that, how to find meaning in the numbers. Tip number one is to compare the numbers you found in your analysis, in your estimations, in the charts that you read with other relevant numbers. So for example, you have a 10 percentage points market share increase that you need to grow. You can compare that with the historical growth in market share for your client. So say for example, that if they follow the historical trend, they will take 10 years to reach those 25% market share targets. What does that mean? Well, it depends on the context of the case. If the client wants to reach that revenue growth target in roughly 10 years, then you can say that they can keep doing business as usual, adapt themselves to the market, but they won't need drastic change. However, if they want to achieve that growth in 2 or 3 years, what that means is that they're going to need some drastic changes. They can't keep doing business as usual in order to grow and reach their targets. Another comparison that you can make, let's say that earlier in the case, you had a table that showed your competitors and the market share of each one, and that there were two competitors with roughly 10% market share. Now, you can connect the dots between these two parts of the case and give your interviewer the hypothesis that they can achieve this revenue growth almost instantly by acquiring either of the two competitors. Now, this is a hypothesis, but because you're comparing these two pieces of data, you're connecting the dots, you're now driving the case and suggesting to your interviewer or in a real life situation to your client what types of opportunities or of options they should consider. Tip number two is to focus on the actions your client should take. So growing from 15% market share to 25% market share might mean that they need to expand geographically. Let's say that you had a chart from earlier in the case showing that your 15% market share comes from a really high market share in one specific region of the country where all of your stores are, and that there are other regions of the country where you don't have a retail presence, and these are regions that have a nice market size and are growing fast. So what this means, the conclusion you might reach is that the only way to grow that much in market share is to expand geographically to these other regions. Let me give you another example. Suppose that you had information from earlier in the case showing that you are really large in one customer segment. So let's say that 15%, your 15% market share comes mostly from dominance in one customer segment, and that you're not really strong in the others. So the conclusion that you might make is that you need to create products, store formats, and build stores in locations that are attractive to other customer segments as well. You need to almost double your market share, and you already dominate your specific customer segment. So in order to grow that much, you need to do these three things to get market share from other customer segments as well. So in order to do an action-oriented insight, you can't just look at the number alone or even comparing just one number with the other. You need to see the number that you got in your analysis and compare it with the context of the case. So it's a little harder to do, but throughout the case, you will get a lot of context. You will get a lot of general information about your client's situation, and you should take advantage of that because that's a really strong way to finish your analysis. Showing the interviewer that you know or you have a hypothesis of what the client should do. As a consultant, you're not hired to compute numbers. You're hired to think about what the implications of certain facts are to your client and to tell them what they should do or to help them understand what they should do. Crunching numbers, doing analysis, these are all intermediate steps into that goal. So never finish an analysis telling the interviewer what the number is. Instead, tell them what the number is and tell them what that means to your client. Now, I'm gonna put on the screen a couple of videos that might be useful to you based on your interest in this one. But if you wanna learn tactics and techniques to make sure you're giving your interviewers what they want at every part of the case, including step-by-step methods to solve the three types of quantitative questions in case interviews, make sure you check out our free course at craftingcases.com/free-course. There's a lot of stuff there, a lot of stuff that you won't find anywhere else, because this is where tactics and techniques that we created to help you perform better in your cases. If you've liked this video, please hit like, so this helps us improve our YouTube rankings. Subscribe to this channel because we put out videos every week. And also, if you have any questions, ask me in the comments and I'll make sure to answer each and every one of them. I hope you've liked this video, and I'll see you in the next one.